8 plus 0 is 8, because that's what 0 is. 0 is defined as the number that if you take some other number and add it to 0, you get that other number back. So 8 plus 0 is 8, and for that reason we have a special name for 0. We call it the identity of addition. Now then we come to this question, what do I add to 8 in order to get back to the identity, in order to get to 0? Well, to answer that question, we made up a whole new kind of number. We made up negative numbers. And we put the negation of 8, negative 8, right in here. And we define that as the number that we have to add to 8 in order to get back to 0. Now, moving on to multiplication, the identity of multiplication is 1, because if I multiply 1 times any other number, I get that other number. So 8 times 1 is 8. But now, what do I multiply 8 by in order to get back to 1? Well, for addition, we had to make up a whole new number in order to figure out 8 plus what equals the identity 0. Well, down here in multiplication, we're going to do the same thing. We're going to make up a whole new number, because that's sometimes what we do in math. When we have a question that we can't find an answer to, that we don't have any sort of number that can fit in this box, we certainly can't put any integers in here. You put in 0, you get 0. 8 times 0 is 0. 8 times 1 is 8. 8 times 2, 8 times 3. All those numbers are going to be higher than 1. 8 times a negative number is a negative number. So we need a new kind of number to go in here. So we are going to make it up. That's right. We're just going to make it up and see what happens. We're going to call this number a reciprocal. And here's how we write it. We write it as 1 over 8. Now you probably recognize this. Looks like a fraction. You've probably seen fractions before. And reciprocal, this is a fraction. It's a very special fraction here. 1 over 8 is the number that we multiply 8 by in order to get 1. And that's how we define this number. Now you might be wondering, how big is this number? It's obviously not negative, because if you multiply 8 by a negative number, you'll get something negative. And 8 times 0 is 0. 8 times 1 is 8. 1 is between 0 and 8. So we figure this 1 over 8 number, that's somewhere between 0 and 1. And it is. If you were to draw a number line, this 1 over 8 number is between 0 and 1, and it's closer to 0. It's right over here. So this is a real number. We can find it right here on the number line. But we've totally made this number up just to answer this question of 8 times what equals 1? And the answer to that question, 1 over 8, is the reciprocal of 8. Now, that's enough about 8. Right? We can do this with any other number. The reciprocal of, well, maybe almost any other number. Let's see. Can we find reciprocals of other numbers? 2, the reciprocal of 2 is 1 over 2. Let's try 1. What's the reciprocal of 1? 1 times what equal? 1 times 1 equals 1. The reciprocal of 1 is 1. All right, easy enough. Let's try another one. The reciprocal of 1 of what? But that is a reciprocal. So we have to find a reciprocal of a reciprocal. What do I multiply 1 over 8 by to get 1? But we just defined 1 over 8 as the number you multiply 8 by in order to get 1. So 1 over 8 times 8 is 1. That's how we defined this number. So the reciprocal of 1 over 8 must just be 8. So the reciprocal of a number, you get the number back. All right, good enough. How about negative numbers? What's the reciprocal of negative 8? Well, I figure the reciprocal has to be negative, because I've got a negative here. If I multiply negative times a positive, I'll get a negative number, not 1. So I figure the reciprocal is going to be negative, but what is it? I would know what to do here if this were a positive number. If we just had 8, we know that the reciprocal of 8 is just 1 over 8. So by definition, that's 1. So let's see what happens here if I multiply negative 8 by the negation of this, by the negative of 1 over 8. Well, I know how to do that. I know how to multiply two negative numbers. You multiply two negative numbers, you get the same thing as if you multiplied their positives. Ah! 8 times 1 over 8, that's just 1. So I know that negative 8 times negative 1 over 8 is 1. So I know what goes in this box. The reciprocal of negative 8 is just negative 1 over 8. All right, so we know how to deal with negatives. We know how to deal with the reciprocal of a reciprocal. We know how to deal with 1. How about 0? So we take 0 and... Wait a second. If I multiply anything by 0, I get 0. It doesn't matter what I put in this box. I'm always going to get 0 out. I can never get 1 out. We can't take the reciprocal of 0. There are very few rules in math about what you can't do. This is one of them. You can't take the reciprocal of 0. And go ahead and try it. You know, bad things happen if you take the reciprocal of 0. Try it. Try it. You're still here. You didn't take the reciprocal of 0. Right? You didn't do it because you wouldn't be here if you did. Bad things happen. You can't take the reciprocal of 0. All right, so repeat after me is one rule about what you can't do. I will not take the reciprocal of 0. I didn't hear you. A little louder. I will not take the reciprocal of 0. All right, that's good. Let's recap. No reciprocal of 0. So what we did here was we made up a whole new number, the reciprocal, just to answer this question. What do I multiply a number by in order to get 1? The number's reciprocal. Now, if we look back to addition, we made up these negatives, made up negation in order to answer this question. And then we use that negation to define subtraction. So if you add a negation, you get subtraction. So what do you think we're going to do down here with multiplication? We start with a number. We multiply by a reciprocal. Adding negation gives you subtraction. Multiplying by a reciprocal, you got it. That's what's coming up next. Division.